That's why I've come to talk to you, Father. I want to leave her.
And go where?
Somewhere else.
With someone else? You're a journalist. You'd leave your aunt for him?
Yes.
With everything she can do for you?
I love him.
How long do you think it would last without money?
I don't know.
Of course you do. What about your mother and me? How long did we last?
I love him.
You think I didn't love her? Well, how long? How long did we last before all the money ran out? It took a month for me to begin stealing from her. It was living like this that killed her. Do what Maud says.
You know, she's forbidden me to see you.
Then she's right. There's no limit to what your aunt can do for you.
Marry me to someone I don't love.
Marry you well.
Do you really think you'll see any of that money?
I already do. She sends me a few shillings each week. Her driver brings it round.
Then I'm part of your bargain.
How else do you think I survive? Don't look at me like that. We're the same, you and I.
Yes, and I could have told you about the lawyers and others I had to pay to keep your father out of jail. Did you tell me about the secret trysts in Hyde Park? A tiny room in Soho? A dirty pub in Fleet Street?
That has nothing to do with you!
Yes, it does. I won't let you make the same mistake as your mother. If you see your friend ever again, I can't be responsible for you. Or your father.
Then tell Miss Croy I'm not leaving until she comes down and sees me.
I've already told her.
Then tell her again and again and again, because I'm not leaving until I talk to her.
She doesn't want to see you.